Hey guys, what's up? This is me, Divyakant, and today we're gonna be doing a camera comparison test between OnePlus 5T and a mid-range DSLR. And while comparing, we were quite surprised with the results. So stay tuned for that, and without any further delay, let's quickly get started. Now, I've been using OnePlus 5T from past couple of months now, and I gotta say that this phone is really doing great, and especially the camera. So we decided to make a camera comparison test with OnePlus 5T and a DSLR. Now the DSLR we have used is a mid-range DSLR, that is Canon 200D. And here we have used the standard 1855mm lens and also kept the pixel count to 16 megapixel and have same focal length of about 27mm to that of OnePlus 5T in order to have a fair comparison test. Now here we kept both the cameras in auto mode, keeping the flash in off state in order to make comparison simple. Now before we get started with the side-by-side comparison, here we'll not reveal which photograph was taken from which camera, and we'll just name the camera A and camera B in order to get an unbiased results. Now the first image is of a deodorant bottle, and here both the cameras captured good amount of details, but the camera A has little brighter image than that of camera B, but the camera A has little low bokeh effect as compared to camera B. So overall, camera B looks great, but camera A has large amount of details. Now next up is the image of a gimbal. Now both of them are well detailed, but the camera A has captured very nice colors, and these are close to the actual colors, whereas camera B washed out the wall color as white, which is not in the actual case, and camera A has managed to capture the good amount of details, which is really close to the natural color. And here is a quite harsh lighting condition with bright sky and the shadowed area of house. And here the camera B worked really well this time, but again over bright the picture, whereas camera A has done a good job by keeping the real colors with the blue sky. Now the next image is taken at complex lighting condition, and both the cameras has great dynamic range and captured both the shadowed area and the bright blue sky. Now the camera B looks overall good, but the color is little inaccurate, whereas camera A has little dull image as compared to B, but it has accurate colors and also captured good amount of details. Now next one is the another photograph, and as you can see, both the cameras have captured the great details pretty accurate, and whereas camera A has balanced exposure, whereas camera B has exposed the image a little bit and little bright in color, and here the picture of camera B looks good overall. And here is the macro shot captured using both the cameras, and as you can see, camera A has the flowers in focus, whereas camera B struggled in focusing, which in turn made the picture little bit out of focus. And also the camera A has captured the colors pretty well and has good amount of colors, whereas camera B failed to capture the actual colors, and here camera A is a definite winner. And here is another close-up shot of a beetroot leaf, and here camera A has captured the color really well but overexposed the shiny area of leaves, whereas camera B has maintained a very good exposure overall and has much more details than that of camera A, and here the camera B has done really good job. Now this picture was taken indoors, and the image from both the cameras are clear and sharp, but the camera B has overbrightened the saturation, resulting in unnatural color of pillow. Whereas camera A has done really well, keeping colors under control, and everything looks natural in camera A. Now this one was taken at quite low light condition, and as you can see, both of them has done really well. Even under low light condition, both has really good noise reduction technology, even at high ISO. But again, the camera B has slightly different color accuracy as compared to camera A. Camera A is much more closer to the natural color of the subject. Now the next image of a flip key remote is taken at extremely low light condition, and both cameras captured nice picture even under this lighting condition. And here we can see a little bit of noise in camera A, whereas camera B managed to reduce the noises to a great extent. And now here is the another picture taken at a very low light condition, and here also both the cameras did really well job, and we couldn't find much difference between the two, and both of them has good clarity, and here it's a tie between both the cameras. Alright guys, we have also done the video test, and we have done the side by side comparison of both the cameras, and here as you can see, both the cameras are doing great job, and here both cameras are capturing good details of the floor including the shadowed area, and both of them have very good color accuracy, and here the camera A has little bit sharper and more closer to flat colors, whereas camera B is capturing good amount of light and colors. And as far as the video stabilization is concerned, the camera camera A has a very good video stabilization, as you can see, whereas camera B failed in video stabilization. And here both the cameras are handheld, and camera A is doing very great in video stabilization. And as far as the focusing is concerned, both of them has face detection autofocusing system, which really works great in both the cameras. So as far as the video quality is concerned, it is completely a personal preference, but as far as the video stabilization is concerned, here camera A is a definite winner. Now finally, this was captured under artificial lighting conditions, and here you can clearly see which photograph was taken from which camera, and here the 5T's image looks good overall, keeping myself as a subject, but the background details is overexposed. The curtain behind me is completely washed out in case of 5T, but DSLR kept everything in control, keeping overall well exposed image. Alright guys, now it's time to reveal the camera, but before moving on, you guys be the judge and you may pause the video and decide which camera was better in your concern. So the camera A was OnePlus 5T's camera, and the camera B was the DSLR, that is Canon 200D. Alright guys, let me know your honest answer in the comment section below, and also let me know which camera won in your rating. But as far as my choice is concerned, I'll definitely choose OnePlus 5T's camera, as it maintained color accuracy and reproduced very natural colors, which was much more accurate in most of the situations. But whereas the auto mode of DSLR really struggled in maintaining the color accuracy, even though it was quite detailed. Alright guys, let me know what you think about this video in the comment section below, and hit the like button if you like this video, and also subscribe to our channel if you haven't subscribed yet, and also hit the bell icon to get notified each time I upload my next video. This is me, Divyakant, and I'll catch you all super soon. Till then, bye bye, take care.